Hi dear students, this is Umesh Rathod, a teacher of English for you all my dear students. I hope you are fit with a great health, okay? We have already started, okay, lesson that is Karna. We have understood the lesson and it is a conversation, okay, among so many characters, okay, like Duryodhana, like there was Bhima, there was Arjuna and there was main important character that is Karna. We have understood and we have discussed questions and answers also, okay? So after the questions and answers, let us discuss something about grammar part of that lesson. Dear students, we have already discussed clauses, conditional clauses, okay? Conditional sentences. So how many type of conditional sentences we have discussed? There are four types. One is zero conditional. Zero conditional, it means what? If you boil water, okay, if you boil ice, okay, it turns into water. So it is what? Zero conditional. It means what? It doesn't take much time, okay, to occur. And next one is the conditional, first conditional, that is if clauses. We are talking about if clauses. In that first zero conditional we have discussed, after that we have discussed first if conditional, okay, first if conditional. What is that? If you study well, you will get good marks, okay? If you maintain social distancing, you will be away from coronavirus. So this is what first conditional. So like that, people say, if you give me dowry, I will marry your Gauri. So that is first conditional, like that. If you get up early in the morning, okay, you will be right, okay, at the office. You will be you will reach at the right time to the office. So like that, we have so many examples, okay? And some students have, you know, they come, they just have a lot of you know, demands for their parents, that if you provide me mobile phone, I will go to college, like that type of conditionals, okay? If conditional, if in short, if it happens like this, it will be the consequences. Ee riti adre ಆ ರೀತಿ ಆಗ್ತದೆ ಅನ್ನುವಂಥ ಒಂದು ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸ್ಗಳು ನಾವು ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ನೋಡ್ತೀವಿ. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ಸ್. ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಸ್ಕಸ್ಡ್ ಆಲ್ರೆಡಿ ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್. ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ವಾಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಡಿ ವೆಲ್, ಯು ವಿಲ್ ಗೆಟ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್, ಓಕೆ? ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಸೆಕೆಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ದಟ್ ಈಸ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ವೆಲ್, ಪಾಸ್ಟ್ ಟೆನ್ಸ್, ನೀನು ಓದಿದ್ದರೆ, ಓಕೆ? ಇಫ್ ಇಂಡಿಯನ್ಸ್ ಸ್ಕೋರ್ಡ್ ವೆಲ್, ಇಂಡಿಯಾ ವುಡ್ ವಿನ್ ದ ಮ್ಯಾಚ್, ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. Okay, if you studied well, you will get good marks. That is first conditional. Second, that is statement. But in the second conditional class, conditional if class, that is, if you studied well, you would pass the examination or you would get good marks. Okay, so that is second conditional. Dear students, we have discussed that also. It means second conditional, it talks about unusual, unreal things. And third conditional, if class. Third conditional, what is the third conditional? Situation or event in the past, okay, it suggests that if things had happened differently in the past, the results would have been different, okay, like that. If suppose some people, you know, complain their parents that if my father had, okay, admitted me towards the science, I would have become engineering graduate, like that, okay. If my parents had supported me, okay, like that. If my brother had supported me, or if my wife had supported me, I would have gone somewhere. Or sometimes wives also complain, okay, wife also complains, what if my husband had supported me, nanna ganda nanage support madidde agiddare, I would have got a good government jobs. So like that, we have third if conditional clauses. Dear students, conditional clauses, conditional if clause means what? If it happens, if it is like this, it will be like that. If it was like that, it would be in that way. Or if it had happened differently, third conditional. If it had happened differently, differently means what? It did not happen like that. So we are just having we have imagination. So what would have happened? Are you getting my words? What would have happened if government had not taken any steps, okay? So we would number of corona cases would have increased, okay? Like that, we can apply grammar and use, okay, grammar in our day-to-day affairs. ನಾವು ದಿನನಿತ್ಯ ಮಾತಾಡಬೇಕಾದ್ರೆ ಗ್ರಾಮರ್ ಅನ್ನು ಬಳಸ್ಕೋಬೇಕಾಗ್ತೈತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದಿಸ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಯೂಸ್ ಇನ್ ಅವರ್ ಡೇ ಟು ಡೇ ಲೈಫ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಹೇಳಿರ್ತಾರೆ, ಸರ್ ಮತ್ತೆ ಮತ್ತೆ ನನಗೆ ಅದೇ ಕಂಟಿನ್ಯೂಸ್ ಆಗಿ ಆರಾಮ್ ತರ್ತಾ ಇದೆ ಸರ್, ಏನು ಸಮಸ್ಯೆ ಅಂದಾಗ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ಸ್ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಟೇಕನ್ ದ ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಪ್ರಾಪರ್ಲಿ ಯು ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕ್ಯೂರ್ಡ್. ನೋಡ್ರಿ, ನೀನು ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸನ್ನು ಮೆಡಿಸಿನ್ಸ್ ಕರೆಕ್ಟ್ ತಗೊಂಡಿದ್ದಾಗಿದ್ದರೆ ನೀನು ಇವತ್ತಿಗೆ ಕ್ಯೂರ್ ಆಗ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಇಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ವಾಟ್? ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ಹಿ ಡಿಡ್ ನಾಟ್ ಟೇಕ್ ದ ಟ್ಯಾಬ್ಲೆಟ್ಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಸೊ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾಪ್ನಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ ದಟ್ ಪರ್ಸನ್. ಇದು ಈ ರೀತಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಮತ್ತು ಪ್ರಿನ್ಸಿಪಾಲ್ಗೆ ಬಂದು ಪೇರೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಬಂದು ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ, ಸರ್ ನನ್ನ ಮಗ ಫೇಲ್ ಆದ ಸರ್, ಏನು ಕಾರಣ ಇರ್ಬೋದು ಅಂದಾಗ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ಸ್ ಪಾಸ್ ಮಾಡಿಲ್ಲ ಅವನು. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್? ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ವೆಲ್ ಹಿ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯುವರ್ ಸನ್ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ವೆಲ್, ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ವೆಲ್, ಯು ವುಡ್ ಹಿ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಗುಡ್ ಮಾರ್ಕ್ಸ್. ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸ್ಟಡೀಡ್ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಗೋ, ಲೆಟ್ ಅಸ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಎ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಸೆಕ್ಷನ್. There we have complete these sentences with the correct forms of the verbs in the brackets. Okay, so we have to complete these sentences. So first one we have, if the doctor comes tomorrow, ondu vela doctor nale bandre conditional. Okay, he dash you, it means he does not dash you, he will examine. Only examine is there, it should be what? Will examine. It is simple present. Tell me which conditional it is. If doctor comes, doctor comes, simple present tense. If simple present tense is the first part of the sentence, okay. So if the doctor comes, it is it main clause or subordinate clause? If doctor comes tomorrow, if doctor comes tomorrow, okay, if doctor comes tomorrow, he will examine you. He will examine you. He will examine you. Okay. Our nina pariksha martara. So this is what sentence. Here we have two parts. Okay. If doctor comes tomorrow, it becomes what? It is a subordinate clause. It is subordinate clause. It is main clause. It is main clause. Okay. So dear students, subordinate, or it is called also dependent clause. It is also called as dependent. I have already discussed this one, dependent clause. Okay, it is called a dependent clause, or it is also called as a subordinate clause. Okay, and that is called as a main clause. Why it is called a subordinate clause? Because this clause becomes incomplete. It does not give complete information. It does not give complete idea. So that's why we use it as a subordinate class or dependent class. Okay, so dear student, it becomes what? It is a first conditional, second or third conditional, or zero conditional. Tell me, if simple present is there in first statement and there is a will, so it is first conditional. It is a first conditional. Make it third, second conditional. We can make it second conditional. How it is? Second conditional, second if conditional. How it is? Look at this. If doctor comes, it becomes came. If doctor came yesterday, tomorrow, it becomes yesterday, because you are talking about past. Okay, second conditional is about past tense. If doctor came yesterday, ಒಂದು ವೇಳೆ ಡಾಕ್ಟರ್ ನಿನ್ನೆ ಬಂದಿದ್ದರೆ, ಓಕೆ, ಸೊ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಒನ್? ಹಿ ವಿಲ್ ಹೋಗಿ ಏನಾಗ್ತದೆ ಇಲ್ಲಿ? ಹಿ ವುಡ್ examine you. He would examine you, or he would treat you. So this is the second conditional. Dear students, you understand? Just look at this conditionals. First conditional it is, second conditional, and let us go for third conditional. What is third conditional? So second conditional, what is that second conditional? It is, second conditional is what? Here you have simple past, okay, and here you will have would. In first one, what we have here? Simple present. It is simple past, simple present, and here we have will. Okay, so third conditional, what is the third conditional, dear students? Third conditional is what? Third if conditional. If doctor, it's not came, it if doctor had come, if doctor had, if doctor had come, doctor bandiddare, bandiddagiddare, so it, if it had occurred
if it had happened differently, it means doctor had not come at that time. Okay,
you are informing a situation which was not happened. Okay, like that it is. If doctor had come that day, adivasa
nodri patient badaktittu antu helthirtar. If doctor had arrived early, patient would have survived like that. So like that my friend would have survived like that. If doctor had, sometimes it happens when people go to the hospitals, so it takes a lot of time and we don't get the doctors immediately. Okay, that's the problem. At that time we have the conditionals. What conditionals you can keep here? If doctor had come that day, he would have examined or treated you. So dear students, this is third condition. What is that? Had plus v3. It means not which tense it is, past perfect tense. If doctor had come that day, what is this here? Would have. What structure we have to use here? Would have plus v3 means not past form of the verb, sorry, past participle or third form of the verb. Write, wrote, written. What is v3 here? V3 is written. Okay, like that. You can make any other examples. Okay, if I get hall ticket, I will write the examination. Okay, if I got hall ticket, simple past, I would write exam. If I had taken hall ticket, I would have written examination. Okay, like that. If you invite me, I will attend your birthday party. Second one, if you invited me, here invite me now, I will attend your birthday party tomorrow. Okay, suppose here he did not invite or she did not invite, that time you have second conditional. What is that? If you invited me, I would come to your birthday party. Okay, third conditional, it is what it is. If it had happened differently, it would have occurred like this. This is the third one. If you had invited me, had plus v3, past perfect tense. If you had invited me, I would have come. ಕೆಲವರು ಇನ್ವೈಟೇ ಮಾಡಿರೋದಿಲ್ಲ, ಆದರೂ ಕೂಡ ನೀವು ನಮ್ಮ ಮದುವೆಗೆ ಬಂದಿರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಓಕೆ, ನೀವು ನನ್ನ ಬರ್ತ್ಡೇ ಪಾರ್ಟಿಗೆ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ, ಸೊ ವೆಡ್ಡಿಂಗ್ ಆನಿವರ್ಸರಿಗೆ ಬರಲಿಲ್ಲ. ಸೊ ಈ ರೀತಿ ಹೇಳ್ತಿರ್ತಾರೆ. ಆಗ ನಾವು ಏನು ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ ಅವರಿಗೆ, ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ಹೇಳ್ತೀವಿ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಇನ್ವೈಟೆಡ್ ಮೀ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಮ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಕಾಲ್ಡ್ ಮೀ ಅಟ್ಲೀಸ್ಟ್ ಒಂದು ಕಾಲ್ ಮಾಡಿದ್ರೂ ಕೂಡ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಅಟೆಂಡೆಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಕಮ್ ಟು ಯುವರ್ ಬರ್ತ್ಡೇ ಫಂಕ್ಷನ್. Okay dear students, understood this one? So second one, what is that? If I were the education minister, I dash more school set up. So what is this? It is past tense. If I were your friend, I would help. ನಾನು ನಿನ್ನ ಸ್ನೇಹಿತನಾಗಿದ್ದರೆ ನಾನು ಹೆಲ್ಪ್ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಐ ವುಡ್ ಹೆಲ್ಪ್. ಓಕೆ, ಸಪೋಸ್ ಸೇಮ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಹಿಯರ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ವೇರ್ ದ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಐ ವುಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಐ ವುಡ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಸ್. ಇಫ್ ಐ ವೇರ್ ಎಜುಕೇಷನ್ ಮಿನಿಸ್ಟರ್, ಐ ವುಡ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಅಪ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಫಿಲ್ ಹಿಯರ್ ವರ್ಡ್ ವುಡ್. ಐ ವುಡ್ ಸೆಟ್ ಅಪ್ ಮೋರ್ ಸ್ಕೂಲ್ಸ್. ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಡ್ಯಾಶ್ ವುಡ್ ಆನ್ ಫೈರ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬರ್ನ್. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಥರ್ಡ್ ಒನ್? ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೆಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಆನ್ ಫೈರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಡೂ? ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೆಟ್ ವುಡ್ ಆನ್ ಫೈರ್, ಅಕಸ್ಮಾತ್ ಕಟ್ಟಿಗೆಗೆ ನೀನು ಬೆಂಕಿ ಹಚ್ಚಿದರೆ, ಬೆಂಕಿ ಹಚ್ಚುವ ಕೆಲಸ ಸಾಕಷ್ಟು ಜನ ಮಾಡ್ತಿರ್ತೀವಿ. ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೆಟ್ ದ ವುಡ್ ಆನ್ ಫೈರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದಿಸ್? ಫಸ್ಟ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಯು ಸೆಟ್ ದ ವುಡ್ ಆನ್ ಫೈರ್, ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬರ್ನ್, ಅದು ಸುಡುತ್ತದೆ, ಲೈಕ್ ದ್ಯಾಟ್. ಓಕೆ, ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಒನ್, ಇಫ್ ಹಿ ಇನ್ವೈಟ್ಸ್ ಯು, ನಾನೇ ಹೇಳಿದೆ ನಿಮಗೆ, ಇಫ್ ಹಿ ಇನ್ವೈಟ್ಸ್ ಯು ಒನ್ಸ್, ಜಸ್ಟ್ ರೈಟ್ ಡೌನ್ ದೀಸ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ ಮೈ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್. ಯು ಡೋಂಟ್ ಫೈಂಡ್ ದಿಸ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟ್ರಕ್ಚರ್ಸ್ ಇನ್ ಎನಿ ಟೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಬುಕ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಎನಿ ವೇರ್. ಓಕೆ, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಎಕ್ಸ್ಕ್ಲೂಸಿವ್ಲಿ ಓಕೆ ಯೂಸ್ಡ್ ಬೈ ಉಮೇಶ್ ಸರ್. ಕೀಪ್ ಇನ್ ಯುವರ್ ಮೈಂಡ್. ಓಕೆ, ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಗಿವನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಒನ್, ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ದೇರ್ ಎನಿವೇರ್. ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಬ್ರಾಟ್ ದಿಸ್
type of structure for you, exclusively for the benefit of my students. Okay, you are my students. That's why I have provided you. Just enjoy this table. Let us go for next one. So may I remove this one, dear students? Okay. So with this today's language, may I delete this one? Yes, I can. Okay, dear students, we are talking about conditional clauses. So we get so many questions. Okay, in banking examinations, in future also, dear students. So fourth one is what it is. If you okay, if he invites you, akas at akasmat invite madre, ahwana kotre. If he invites you, okay, dash to his birthday party. It means what? Do you go to his birthday party or will you go to his birthday party? What is correct, dear students? Yes, exactly correct. Will you go to birthday party? Okay, if he invites you, will you go to his birthday party? Like that. Suppose will BJP invite you? Okay, will you join their party? Like that. Okay, so many times we get this news like that. Okay, so at this time we are discussing about conditional clauses. Okay, if he invites you, so I told you that second conditional, make it second conditional. If he invited you, or if I invited him, or if she invited me, okay, I would go. Okay, second conditional. And third conditional for this, if he had invited. Next one, dear students, fifth one. If I dash down this offer, I would have regretted it all my life. Okay, what is this one? So fifth one is, if I had turned down this offer, it is third conditional, these questions I will ask in the midterm examination, dear students. Please take care of these topics. If I had turned down this offer, I would have regretted it all my life. It means what? If I had not accepted this offer, I would have regretted. Na ee offer na nanu reject madidre nanu balashtu paschata padtaide. Like that. If I had not accepted his proposal, I would have regretted. Like that. Okay, if I had not attended his classes, I would have lost lot of things. Like that we use. Okay, so dear students, we are talking about complete the sentences with the correct forms of the verbs in the brackets. And sixth one is, if the brakes fail, what happens if the brakes fail? Okay, this you have to understand. Conditional. If the brakes fail, don't drive the car. Okay, if the brakes fail, don't drive the car. Okay, many times we have seen the accidents after failing in the brakes. Okay, dear students, if you find any such difficulties, you can ask me, you can call anytime. Okay, just have these classes and you can pause this video and again you can watch this one. If the brakes fail, what happens? Don't drive the car. Okay, so if you don't have driving license, don't go outside. Like that. If you don't have your previous cards, admit cards, don't go to the hospital. Like that. Okay, people advise you like this, conditional clauses. If you don't have hall ticket, admit card, don't enter into the examination hall. So like that we use. Next we have B section, that is rewrite these sentences as conditional sentences. They are not conditional sentences, but make them conditional sentences. Okay, so what is the first one? Oil floats on water. It is scientific fact. It is oil floats on water. Okay, enne neerin mele telutade. Yak telutade? If you are a student of students of science, you should have the answer with you. So why does oil float on? Okay, because density of water is more, or oil is more. Just you imagine, think, okay, understand and answer. But it is not scientific question. We are talking about conditional sentence. We have to make it conditional sentence. What is the conditional sentence we can make? If you pour oil on water, it floats. Okay, if you pour, what it is, if you pour oil on water, if you, first one, if you pour pour then suryodo if you pour oil on water what it does it floats. Dear students, it becomes a zero conditional. It is a zero conditional sentence. Okay, because as soon as you do this one, it happens. That is zero conditional. Okay, if you pour oil on water, okay, it floats. So why it floats? Okay, you just have understood that it's a because of density. And second one, you must take a walk every day. You must take walk every day. You will feel more energetic. You must take these medicines. Okay, you will be very fine. So like this, you have to make these conditional sentences. What is this? You must take a walk every day. Okay, see, a morning walk in the park. Okay, gives a lot of refreshment. Okay, makes you feel better, comfortable, because morning. Okay, nature is at its best morning, especially in the morning. There is absence of traffic and lot of sounds are also not found that time, and singing of the birds and lot of cool and very wonderful air you get that time. Okay, you must take a walk every day. Every day, okay, you will feel more energetic. What's the conditional sentence? What is the conditional sentence, dear students? Use if here. What happens if you take a walk every day? You will feel more energetic. If you take a walk every day, dina morning walk madidre, okay, what happens? If you take, it's a conditional sentence. It is a condition. If you take a walk every day, every day. Okay, actually pronunciation of that England. What is that? Die. Okay, every day. Okay, if you take walk every day. So what happens? What's the consequences here? You will feel more energetic. Okay, that is what conditional sentence. Next one. You look down and see a lizard on your foot. You look down and see a lizard on your foot. What will you do? So it is a sentence, general sentences. We have to make it a conditional sentence. What is the conditional sentence here? If you look down and see a lizard on your foot, what will you do? Okay, if you look down and see a snake, what will you do? Sir, I catch the snake and I just take it towards my home. Is it possible? Can you play with the snakes? It's very dangerous. It's very poisonous. Okay, what will you do? So this is a conditional sentence. What is conditional sentence? You look down. Before that, you just add a word. Begin this one with a if and remove the full stop after your foot. After your foot is there, that full stop should be removed, and beginning of the sentence should have which word? If. This becomes a conditional sentence. How it is? If you look down and see a lizard on your foot, comma, what will you do? Are you getting my words? How easy it is to make it a conditional sentence. Okay. Floor and water make dove. Okay. What is this? If you mix a floor and water, it becomes dove, not rough, dove. Okay. If you mix floor and water. Floor and water, okay, hittu mattu neerannu koodisidaga nodri, so we have to mix, okay, that floor and water. What it becomes? It becomes dough. Okay, if you mix floor and water, it becomes dough. Next, fifth one, add more salt, the soap will taste better. Add more salt. What happens here? If you add more salt, the soup, okay, will taste better. Soup, not soap, it's a soup. Okay, add more salt. What happens? If you add more salt, the soup will taste better. Okay, sometimes if you take a second conditional class, if you added salt, okay, the soup would, okay, taste better. Third conditional, if you had added, okay, salt, the soup would have tasted better. So like this, we can make three conditionals. Okay, add more salt. Okay, I could not send you a postcard while on holiday. I did not have your address. What is the conditional sentence? It is if I had. Okay, what is the conditional sentence here? If I had your address, okay, I would have sent. If I had got your address, I would have sent you a postcard. ಓಕೆ ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ ಗೊತ್ತಿದ್ರೆ ನನಗೆ ಕಳಿಸ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೆ. ಓಕೆ ಇಫ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್ಡ್, ಇಫ್ ಐ ಹ್ಯಾಡ್ ಗಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಅಡ್ರೆಸ್, ಐ ವುಡ್ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಸೆಂಟ್ ಯು ಓಕೆ ದಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ಸ್. ಸೊ ಲೈಕ್ ದಿಸ್ ಡಿಯರ್ ಸ್ಟೂಡೆಂಟ್ಸ್, ವಿ ಕ್ಯಾನ್ ಯೂಸ್ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಐ ಟೆಲ್ ಸಮ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದೆಮ್, ಯು ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಟು ಮೇಕ್ ದೆಮ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಒನ್, ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ಟೂ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಕಂಡೀಷನ್ ನಂಬರ್ ತ್ರೀ. ಸೊ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಯು ಮೇಕ್ ದ ಕಂಡೀಷನಲ್ ಸೆಂಟೆನ್ಸಸ್, ಐ ಜಸ್ಟ್ ಗಿವ್ ಯು ಸಮ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ so I just give some examples. Okay, some sentences you make them condition number 2 and 3. Okay, first one, if you don't study, you will not get good marks. How it is? If you don't invite, I will not come. If you did not invite, I would not come. If you had not invited, I would not have come. Like that, you have to make this one. How? It is a condition number 1. You have to make condition number 2 and condition number 3. Condition number 1 I have written. Condition number 2 you have to write. Okay? How it is? You just to make it past, did not. And make it third conditional, had not. Okay? So this is conditional sentence, dear students, first one. So next example I give you. If you practice well, you will win the race. For this also you can make, for this also you can make condition number 2 and condition number 3. Okay, dear students, so like this you practice. Okay, remaining things, it is we have vocabulary. Okay, in vocabulary we have figures of speech. After that we have again rewrite the sentences we have. Okay, we'll discuss that also. Okay, thank you for listening and watching the class. I will continue next things, vocabulary and listening, speaking and reading and writing part in my next video. These are very important. Okay, only reading the answers and writing in the examination is not a part of student's life. Learning the language completely, it's very important because it is permanent. What is there after the lessons, no, that's vocabulary, listening, speaking, writing and whatever grammar parts. It is permanent. You will study this next year also. If you don't understand them this year, it will be very difficult for you to understand 9th class. Okay, that's why I'm going in very details, okay, for these topics. Thank you very much. Take care. Bye.